God, I thank you for his charm, his sense of humor, his intelligence, and his heart. Thank you for giving me a man that truly loves me like you do. In oceans deep, my faith will stand. Wisdom and knowledge. God, I ask that you continue to mold him into the godly man you created him to be. I pray that he always remains grateful for everything he has. Lord, I pray that he is never too prideful to ask for help. I ask that everything his hand touches that you bless and allow it to prosper. Give him the boldness that he needs to live for you and for his faith. And I pray that any struggles and hard seasons that he may face, that he knows that you are present. Give us the tools to be better partners to each other, and I pray that we always remember the qualities that attracted us to each other, and that we continue to grow, love, and work together for the rest of our lives. I pray that we always have love and laughter in our home, that we live through a long and healthy marriage, discover our purpose, and continuously support one another through every season of life. Thank you for your faithfulness to us, God, and I pray your grace and mercy in times to come. We thank you. We praise you in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen.
Spirit, lead me where my trust is without borders. Let me walk upon the waters wherever you would come.
Hanging out at CJ's house, playing FIFA, we decided to go to the gym, and he figured it out for me. From that night on, you've been my best friend. Person that's always been there for me. Person that would do anything for me. You show me what love is. I know life will get hard. It will not be easy, but I promise you something here today. I will be there for you. I will care for you. I will love you to my last breath. So, as this story continues, the most comforting feeling is knowing that you'll be there by my side. I wouldn't have it any other way. You've always been the one, and now you'll be forever.
Thank you for sticking by me through seasons of doubt and fear. All of the years I spent without you, God was preparing me for the big things and fixing my heart to appreciate the little ones. He guided me through deep waters that led me straight to you. I have found the one who my soul loves. I have found the one who I used to pray for, and now the same one is the man I pray with. The Bible says in Ruth 1:16, through 17. For where you go, I will go. For where and where you live, I will live. Your people shall be my people, and your God, my God. Where you die, I will die, and there will I be buried. May the Lord do so to me, and more also if anything but death parts me from you.
Say, I, Jonathan.
Take you, Madison.
To be my wedded wife.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
For better or for worse.
For richer or for poorer.
In sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish. As long as we both shall live. So to you alone.
I promise.
With the blessing of God.
To be your faithful husband.
Now, Madison. Repeat after me. I'm Madison. Take you, Jonathan. To be my wedded husband. To have and to hold. From this day forward. For better or for worse. For richer or for poorer. In sickness and in health. To love and to cherish. As long as we both shall live. So to you alone. I promise, with the blessing of God, to be your faithful wife. Do this as often as you drink it, in remembrance of me. Amen. In the symbol of the cup, we participate in the new life Christ brings. So let us pray. We give thanks, loving God, that you have refreshed us at your table. Bless this time and this moment, and bless your children in this couple. In Jesus' name, amen. You may come back forward this way. And as a symbolic act, can we extend our hands to this couple? Lord, we thank you for this commitment and what you are doing at this moment. Thank you for this sacred moment that you have blessed Maddie and Jonathan with. Lord, we ask you that this is just the beginning of something beautiful and amazing. That, Lord, that when the good times happen, that they can look back at this moment of commitment. When rough times happen, that they may look back at this moment of commitment. And Lord, that they would be an example to all those that are witnessing here today, that their marriage would be an example to others. I pray, Lord, for a divine unity in their marriage, and that this would be a moment, not just for good memories or a picture, but when they're going through all these different seasons of life, they can look back and be reminded of this commitment. We bless them, we bless their generations, and we bless their children, their children's children. Because Lord, this is about legacy. And we thank you for what you're doing here. In Jesus' name, amen. And now as you, Jonathan, and you, Madison, have consented in holy matrimony, and have witnessed the same before your God, families, and friends, by virtue of the authority vested in me as a minister of the Word of God, and by the laws of the state of Pennsylvania, I now pronounce you husband and wife.
So happy together. If I should call you up, invest a dime, and you say you belong to me, ease my mind. Imagine how the world could be so very fine, so happy together. Toss the dice, it had to be. The only one for me is you, and you for me. So happy together.